From the depths of Middle-earth to the mountains of Skyrim, it seems that giant spiders have fully infested the genre of fantasy. Hi, my name's Dave Snodgrass, and today on Table Ready Gaming, I want to show you an easy and affordable way to bring these giant eight-legged monstrosities to your gaming table.
So we're going to start with these rubber spiders that I got at the Halloween store for like $2. I think we got a pack of 10. Then we're going to take these pins that have the little ball at the top there. We're going to need 8 of those because we're going to be upgrading the spider's eyeballs. So take each pin and just clip the very top off. You want to make sure you add a little bit of a bit at the bottom, not too much, because we're going to be sticking that in all the green stuff we'll be putting down later. And then just do that 7 more times. And that's what we should have it look like when you're done clipping them all. All right, the next thing we're going to have to do is shave off the spider's eye with our X-Acto blade, because these spiders come with 2 eyeballs and we need to give them 8. So the next part is we're going to be mixing up some green stuff. This is a 2-part epoxy. Go ahead and pull the middle out where it touches here, because this part tends to harden, and especially with older green stuff like this, that's pretty rock solid, so just go ahead and discard that. And then we're just going to start pushing this together until we get a nice green color consistent throughout. You want to make sure you the color is well mixed, or else you're gonna have hard spots in the green stuff as you start to sculpt with it, and that'll make it very difficult to work with. And when you're done, it should look something like that. So our next step is we're just going to take our green stuff and we're going to start rolling it into a sausage. And this is going to make, again, help it mix up a little bit more, but also just get in the general shape of what we need it for the spider sculpt. Because we're going to be putting this down for his eyeballs. Now when you're working with this green stuff, you're going to make sure that you keep water on hand or some way to lubricate it. With this small amount, I just use a little bit of saliva, to be honest. A little gross, but it gets the job done. And then we're going to lay our green stuff over where the eyeballs used to be and just trim off the excess with an X-Acto blade. Put that other green stuff aside. We're going to be using that for later. And then just start using your fingers to start kind of pushing the green stuff into the space and kind of make a little bit of a ridge there that we're going to be able to push our pins into to make the eyeballs. And again, don't be super worried about sculpting and having a really clean sculpt, because we're going to be texturing over this, so thumbprints and this green stuff won't be the end of the world. And we sculpt. And we sculpt. And then we sculpt some more. And keep on sculpting. We want to make sure we get that nice and flush to So now we're going to start putting our eyeballs into the green stuff. Again, that little bit of a leftover for the pins, you can put that in there and just kind of push that down there to make sure that it's nice and secure. So you don't have to worry about glue or anything like that. We just need to go ahead and basically do that 8 more times, positioning the eyes where we want them. This is probably the most time-consuming part of the build, getting those eyes right where we want it. But I do think this really takes our spider to the next level and kind of stops it, moves it from a cartoony rubber Halloween spider to something that's kind of creepy looking. And if you want to, this is a good time to also Google like spider faces, and you can kind of get an idea of what the layout of the eyes will look like on a spider. I didn't worry about it too much because this is obviously a fantasy monster, so I'm not super worried about ultra realism with this build here. And then you can also just kind of push the eyes around in the green stuff to get them exactly where you want them while you wait for them to dry. And there it is, all dried. Then we're gonna take a little more green stuff and we're just gonna sculpt around the eyes and make sure we're covering off any little tips that are coming off of the pinheads. This will also help secure the eyes in, so there's no reason to have to glue this or any applying glue. When this green stuff cures, those things will be secure in there and will not be coming out. And then you can see us a little bit further along in the sculpting process. There's really no science to this part of it. We just kind of add it where we think we need it and then use our sculpting tools to press it down. Don't be super worried about getting thumbprints in this part of the green stuff, as especially the big blob on the top is going to be covered up by texture that we add later to the model. Then once all the eyes are in place, we can move on to the next step and just kind of start making sure that we build up around those and really makes look like the eyes are embedded in there. Though in the end, I would err to having too much of the eye showing instead of too little, as I think it really makes them pop off the miniature. And again, you can keep moving the eyes around until you get them exactly where you want them, until that green stuff cures up. But that's what our spider face is going to look like when we're done. And there's our spider face, all sculpted. Isn't it beautiful? Next, we're just gonna take a base. These are plastic bases from Games Workshop. And I like them because they have a nice lip. Also, I'll explain more of this in a future video, but it's a really handy way of simply gluing a magnet to the bottom of these and being able to store the miniatures. And to do that, we just use some super glue and press firmly while we wait for that magnet to dry. Again, I'll do another video later on how I store my miniatures with magnets, but I figured people might ask what the silver thing is on the bottom, and it's not a weight, it is in fact a magnet. And next, we're just going to mix up a little bit of green stuff here, and we're going to sculpt basically a small rock in the middle of the base. Start by making some nice hard edges on there as we push this around. Again, this doesn't have to be perfect or super detailed, as the miniature will be covering up the majority of this rock. With a little bit of extra texture, we can cheat by simply pushing a rock into our green stuff to get a nice stone texture on the front of it. And then just make sure the rock smooths nicely into the base. Then we're going to take a pin, poke a hole in our green stuff, and let it cure. Generally, I would let the green stuff cure overnight before working with it anymore. Then take a pin vise, and we're going to drill a small hole in the bottom of our spider. Then we take a sewing pin and we just stick that pin side sharpened into the spider. Since it's this soft rubbery material, it pushes in there really easily. And then we're just going to clip it off and apply some super glue to the pin. And then we're going to push that pin into the top of the hole we made in our green stuff rock. And as you can see, this will start to lift the spider up off the base, which makes him a little bit more three-dimensional, and I think really starts to give life to this otherwise flat rubber spider. Then I went ahead and just sprayed the base with a super glue accelerator to speed up this next process. So then we're going to start taking the tips of the legs and gluing them to the base of that accelerant. Again, this isn't really connecting the model to the base. We've already done that with our green stuff and our pin and our rock that we made. So if you want to get a little bit more advanced, you could probably make a little bit more of an ornate base, perhaps having the spider climbing over a larger rock or scampering up the side of the wall or something like that. But gluing these legs down and raising the body up, I think really makes these spiders add an extra level to them. And that super glue accelerant makes this job go by a whole lot faster, but is not actually necessary to this part. Okay, and then you could kind of see it with the four legs already glued down, and we're just going to go ahead and do the other four on the other side of the spider real quick. And there's our spider on the base with the legs attached. Okay, so for this next step, we're just gonna go ahead and take some PVA glue, or just white Elmer's glue, and start applying it to the top of our spider. Make sure you avoid the eyes, and I also decided to avoid the mandibles and the little mouthy bits on the front of the spider. Then once all the glue has been applied, we're gonna go ahead and take some green flock and apply that to the top of the spider. This is the same stuff that you see model guys using all the time for grass, to base model railroads, terrain, miniature war game bases too. And then we're just gonna go ahead and tap off any excess. And now our spider looks like he's ready to steal Christmas.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch.
So since this video is getting very long, I'm going to go ahead and speed up the painting process on this. Started by spraying the spider black. I did this with an airbrush, but you could easily do it with a rattle can. And then giving it a quick dry brush of gray over it. I then painted the spiders with a few metallics from the scale 75 range. And I'll go ahead and list those down in the description below. But you want to start with a nice mid-range, a little bit of a dark, and then I went back with a very bright silver to make the very tips of the eyes stand out. After that, we just paint the stone in the middle a nice solid gray, And there you can kind of see how our spider looks all painted up. The last step is, again, just to apply basing, and I'll go over basing more in a future video and let you know how exactly I do that. So after the basing has been done, we just did a quick dry brush, paint it, added some few extra stones to break up the fact that there's just one stone on the base, and that's our spiders. Hope you enjoyed.